That day, a gay maker named Brendan, his wife Claire, and their daughter named Sam are on vacation to a beach. Together, the three of them appreciate their happiness, jokes, and laughter. Sam plans to search the beach for snails while they are unwinding, and she swears not to have fun in the water. Claire consents as long as Sam stays within their line of sight. Sam is too preoccupied searching for snails to notice that her inquisitive George is being pulled by the waves. Sadly, as Sam reaches for the doll, the waves drag her away. Both Brendan and Claire are devastated by Sam's passing. While Claire makes an effort to move on, Brendan, who adores his daughter dearly, finds it difficult to let her go. A book named The Berenstain Bear is inadvertently discovered by Brendan as they are packing Sam's belongings. This makes him uncomfortable because he is certain that the book was once called The Berenstain Bear, with a A-E instead of a A. As they are sleeping, there is an odd noise coming from the kitchen. It turns out to be Matt, his brother-in-law, coming to check the refrigerator for food. After that, Brendan gives him some pizza and queries Matt regarding the book The Berenstain Bear. Matt responds, using the letter E, that the book is called The Berenstain Bear. However, Brendan demonstrates to Matt that The Berenstain Bear, with an an, is the proper writing. Brendan searches for it online out of curiosity and discovers that many people believe the writing in the book to be The Berenstain Bear, spelled with an E. Brendan keeps looking for information about it and eventually discovers the Mandela Effect theory, which explains the incident. Brendan gets confused by his family's picture on the refrigerator the following day. Brendan asks his wife where the picture was taken, to which she responds that it was in front of the Griffith Observatory. However, Brendan is certain that the photos were actually taken at the Pacific Science Center in Seattle. His wife tells him to go because she's cooking and doesn't answer. After that, Brendan visits Matt and discusses the Mandela Effect theory. Brendan believes he is witnessing the Mandela Effect, but Matt disputes this, claiming it is simply a hallucination. However, Brendan continues to support his theory and thinks he is now a part of a parallel universe. Brendan looks into these theories further and discovers on the forum that an experiment using a Large Hadron Collider built by CERN is the source of the Mandela Effect. In Russia in 2008, an experiment was carried out concurrently with a number of odd occurrences, including the Mandela Effect. Brendan then makes an attempt to see Isaac, a priest, in order to learn more about God's existence. However, after hearing what Isaac had to say, Brendan is no longer convinced that God is the creator of the universe. Claire tries to remind Brendan not to cling to memories of Sam after noticing his odd behavior. She wants for Brendan to move on from his past and start a new life. Next, he asks his spouse about the image of the man in the Monopoly. Claire believes with all her heart that the guy in Monopoly has a monocle on one eye. It turns out that the guy's image is not wearing a monocle when she checks it. Moreover, Brendan draws attention to the fact that Curious George, the monkey character, is missing his tail. However, Sam's Curious George doll has a tail. Brendan attempts to clarify that each of these has a connection to the Mandela Effect theory. Brendan believes that Sam's passing at that point was simply the result of another parallel universe version entering the real world and altering the course of events. However, Claire is upset and dissatisfied with Brendan because he only thinks about himself and his bizarre theories, which prevents them from moving on. Brendan is still convinced that the Mandela Effect is real, though. Brendan then delves further into the theory. He learns that the possibility of other parallel universes blending into the one he is currently living in could cause the Mandela Effect. There are many parallel universes in existence, and each one has a different version of the present life story. He believes that Sam is probably still alive in a parallel reality. In the end, he discovers the name of Dr. Roland Fuchs, a scientist who shares his belief that this world is merely a simulation. Brendan then makes an attempt to see Dr. Roland, but he is currently too busy. Brendan tries to see him again the following day. There, they talk with each other regarding Roland's research. According to the doctor, his research indicates that the universe is a computer simulation created for an undisclosed reason. Then, every second, the simulation generates new simulations with an alternate telling of the story. Brendan's experience with the Mandela Effect is a bug, or a combination of the current simulation and other simulations. That's the reason why things go wrong in life. Brendan deduces from Roland's explanation that if this world is formed by a program, he can modify it with script coding to make it function flawlessly and error-free. However, it appears that using a regular computer is the only way he can't accomplish that. Dr. Rowland concurs that a common computer with inadequate specifications is insufficient to transform the world. Afterwards, Rowland demonstrates to Brendan that he and his group have created the first quantum computer housed in a single university. Then, according to Dr. Rowland, there's a chance that Brendan's program could be executed on the quantum computer. Brendan then makes the decision to begin researching and writing scripts based on books on quantum computer programming. In order to write a new script, he also blends some of his game programming code with quantum code. When Sam shows up at their house the following day, Brendan is taken aback. He initially believes that it is all in his head, but in the end, he comes to believe that he is the one who returns Sam from the parallel universe. Brendan then makes the most of it by spending time with his daughter without wasting any time. Brendan is pleased that he was able to create a different parallel version of Sam's death story. However, Brendan starts to notice something off about Claire's actions at that point. He understands that Sam is still alive in the parallel version he is currently seeing, but Claire has turned into a very anxious person. Brendan abruptly goes to see Dr. Rowland, but he is taken aback to learn that Rowland killed himself 2 months prior. He believes he entered a script that had a remarkable Mandela effect. Brendan immediately decides to write a coding script to execute the command to reinstall the universe after noticing a bug in the script. The goal of the reinstallation is to fix any bugs, such as the Mandela effect, so that the universe functions normally. Brendan has doubts about the script because he fears the universe will end and cannot be recreated. However, Brendan chooses to go to the location of the quantum computer and begin entering his coding script for the benefit of his wife and daughter. After Brendan successfully executes his script, the quantum computer begins to respond. Brendan notices that every car in the parking lot is missing as he quickly speeds off. He notices that everyone is beginning to glitch on the bus. He notices glitches in the buildings too. When Brendan visits his family after that, he discovers that things have not gone as planned. The building goes dark as he witnesses his wife acting strangely. He witnesses the collision of two moons at the end, and then the universe vanishes into nothingness. Brendan's script abruptly runs again a moment later, and the world starts to reassemble. All life on Earth, including planets, bacteria, viruses, sea life, humans, and entire cities, has returned to normal, with no further anomalies or glitches. The scene then recurs at the beach with Brendan, Claire, and Sam present. Sam gets a call from Brendan telling her to leave the Curious George doll, which appears to be missing its tail, while she is out hunting for snails. Finally, Brendan watches his daughter while Sam searches for snails. And the movie ends. If you like our video, please consider subscribing our channel. Thank you.